I'm Will Price, assistant editor, and these are the 10 best products in drink and drinkware of 2019. First up, our top recommendation, Four Roses Small Batch Select is our editor's pick. This spring, the Four Roses Distillery announced the first update to its mainline bourbon collection in 13 years. It's called Four Roses Small Batch Select. Four Roses was introduced in 1888, and by the 1930s, it became America's top-selling bourbon. In the 40s, a company called Seagram bought the brand and moved sales overseas, creating sort of an extreme lull in popularity in the US. Then in 2002, Kirin Brewery took over the brand and developed three expressions that developed a cult following. Brent Elliott, the current Four Roses Master Distiller, spent over a year figuring out the ideal blend for Small Batch Select. Luckily, Four Roses uses 10 distinct recipes. Each recipe is a different combination of a mash bill and a yeast strain, which sets them apart from other bourbon distilleries. The 10 recipes are mixed and matched to create the brand's different expressions and act as a foundation for all Four Roses expressions. The new Four Roses Small Batch Select is a blend of 6 out of the 10 recipes, each aged for at least 6 years, 4 of which appeared in the 130th anniversary Small Batch bottling, which was named World's Best Bourbon in this year's World Whiskey Awards, sort of a really hyped whiskey that came out earlier this year. Small Batch Select is also the most premium Four Roses to ever see wide release. At $55 retail, it's the highest priced booze of the permanent collection, and in line with current sort of whiskey trends, it also weighs in at the highest proof, and the company also skips the chill filtration process, which lends sort of a fatty mouthfeel to it. Limited editions are often released in short supply and are typically pretty expensive, but with Small Batch Select, it's widely available and sort of the next logical step for the distillery, and a great service to fans who sort of want more high-end bourbon, but with more availability than the limited releases allow. So Shacksbury Shorts finds itself lined up against Goliaths like White Claw and Trolley, but it may sort of be the sleeper champion of 2019's hard seltzer war. The cider is based in Vermont and their product is made with New England apple cider base. It features a touch of citrusy botanicals for complexity. It's light and bright with a champagne-like aftertaste. In short, it makes other hard seltzers taste like sugar bombs. Old Forester's entry-level 100-proof rye is kind of a whiskey chameleon. It's rich enough to sip neat with a splash of water, and also works really well in Manhattan. It's cheap enough to serve as a house whiskey. It's also available year-round across the country, so consider it up there with bottom-shelf greats like Wild Turkey 101 and Evan Williams Black. 3 years ago, a group of Allagash employees set out on a long canoeing expedition and wanted to bring beer. They didn't want to bring the heavier, higher ABV Belgian-style ales the brewery has become famous for, so they decided to make River Trip. River Trip is a Belgian-style session ale that drinks like a hoppier, lighter version of Allagash White. Combined with local pale malt, local raw quick oats, and coriander, Allagash dry hopped the beer with Comet and Azaka hops. If you're not in the know, dry hopping is a brewing technique that brings out sort of more floral and fruity qualities of hops while suppressing natural bitterness. In River Trip, that means balanced notes of grapefruit, melon, stone fruit shine through more so than the traditionally more hoppy beers Allagash puts out. The brewery also opted to can condition River Trip, a traditional carbonation method that adds sort of a small amount of yeast and sugar just before canning, which makes the beer taste fresher for longer. The final product is a 4.8% ABV, 170 calorie ale in a 16 ounce can that effectively integrates the best parts of American craft beer into traditional Belgian beer styles. Legend is the first wide release standalone bourbon brand from Beam since the Jim Beam Small Batch collection was introduced almost 30 years ago. It's a joint project between both arms of the Beam Suntory whiskey making empire. Legend begins a straight Kentucky whiskey produced and aged for about 4 years at Jim Beam's Claremont, Kentucky distillery. A portion is then finished in sherry barrels and another portion is finished in red wine barrels. Those three whiskeys are then blended to merge styles from opposite sides of the world into a neat 94 proof package. The red wine and sherry casks round out the bourbon spiciness, sort of like what they do with Scotch's peatiness. And with Japanese blending techniques that sort of famously layer complexity on top of a more delicate base, the whiskey itself has a lot of nuance. It's way well different from the kind of rough cut bourbons of the past, and achieves a flavor that is sort of both American and Japanese at once. The folks behind George Dickel made a very big decision when they chose not to showcase the whiskey's 13-year-old age statement on the bottle. Age statements have become rarer and rarer, and older whiskeys are known to sell very well. Regardless, this is a ludicrously cheap $36 bottle and bond whiskey. Just look for the words distilling season fall 2005 on the label and buy as many bottles as you can as soon as you can. The Finnish long drink is a carbonated gin-based grapefruit-forward alcoholic soda. It doesn't really fit into another category of American booze. It's not really a spiked seltzer, and its founders would not call it a canned cocktail. It's called a lonkero, where it was invented in Finland, and it allegedly was invented by the Finnish government to satisfy tourists during the Summer Olympic Games of 1952. The four friends behind the long drink company have now made available stateside. It tastes a little bit like a Fresca, but without the more syrupy aftertaste. The six shapes in this glassware collection are sized to factor in liquid displacement, or the lack of it, from your choice of ice. Riedel has consulted with bar consultant Zane Harris to create a collection which includes glasses specifically for rocks, highballs, sours, fizz, neat cocktails, etc. There's also a matching mixing glass and spirits decanter to round out the set. Dim launched in early 2019 with a small four-piece collection, including a very nice bar cart. The Barbican Trolley, designed by a New York-based industrial design studio called Visibility, is made from steel and ashwood. Dim sets itself apart from other affordable direct-to-consumer-like furniture brands in its approach. So instead of recreating or copying more classic or more established designs in the furniture space, Dim's works with these designers to create new designs, create new products, create new looks, and they share a small percentage of each sale with that designer. The studio describes the Barbican as an architectural take on the bar cart. The ashwood handle seamlessly extends from the top shelf, sort of like a cantilever, while the bottom tier's retaining wall opens up to way more possibilities than just beverage duty. And all that may seem kind of like a little too much extra detail for something designed as a home for bottles of liquor, but that's sort of the point of Dim's, or what they're trying to provide, is sort of a more thoughtful design at approachable price points. California startup Haus may very well be the first direct-to-consumer booze brand in the United States. The company produces an aperitif-like expression, which is sold exclusively online. They use grapes, sort of like wine, and clock in just under 24% ABV. Haus, therefore, can bypass state's mandated three-tier distribution system. The citrus flower expression is the brand's first offering. It blends unoaked Chardonnay with lemon, cane sugar, hibiscus, grapefruit, elderflower, and cinnamon for sort of a low-sugar answer to the Aperol craze of last year.